Just fine.
Good, you're wonderful. You're really doing a very healthy, good vacation.
Well, yes, it was wonderful.
I'm so glad.
Everybody was telling me to take it easy, but...
you didn't sound like you were going to do it.
Nice to see you again. How are you?
So glad to see you. I'm glad to see you.
How are you?
I've just got to tell you before you, and then I want to hear about you and some ideas of yours. I got a letter that was so surprised from an old friend, George Montgomery, the actor.
Yes.
Was once married to Dinah Shore, you know. Well, I got a letter from him after all these years. And George was just back from Russia. And he was there in a movie that was a joint thing between the America producer and Yugoslavia. But the locale was in Russia. Well, he told me about how, and just casually remarked that he could speak Russian and understood Russian. And I'd forgotten entirely that his parents, that's his heritage. His George Montgomery's his movie name. I don't know what his real name is, but he said how out there and meeting the people as you would shooting on location and people of every stripe and size in different parts of Russia. And he remarked about over there coldness about us and about me particularly, and then he, being able to talk to them in Russia, knowing me personally, he would he'd give them a different rundown, and he said immediately they were converted, and he spoke about it, but he said the amazing thing when we went to Moscow and all, that he went through customs in and out without anyone going through his bags. They treated him wonderfully when he got to Moscow, like a favored visitor and so forth, a limousine and a driver and so forth. And he went on with this whole thing about the warmth of the people and all that he talked to.
Well, they are. They're wonderful. I want to ask you something, Ken, before we do something serious. You know that wonderful joke you told me?
Briefing. So wherever he sits, it's, that's what I'm kind of wait and see. Well, I mean, if he's down there, the president's going to be looking that way.
Particular reports here today, and Max, you're on first.
Thank you, sir. I'm going to talk about the fall legislative schedule, Mr. President, and probably know where to start.
I don't know why.
I only have 15 minutes, so I try to keep it down to the very details. I think the first thing that we want to talk about, of course, is your tax reform proposal. You unveiled that on May 28th, and as you know, hearings have been going on since May 30th when the Secretary testified, right up until August the 1st. There's a retreat this weekend, which I'm sure the Secretary will be attending. And following that retreat with the Ways and Means Committee, formal drafting of the bill, markup will proceed. We're hoping to have that on the floor sometime around the 1st of August, the 1st of October. No. 1st of October, and hopefully completed by the middle of October in time to meet the Senate schedule to take it up October 15th, probably November 1st, if they have some additional hearings over there and have the bill acted upon in both houses by Thanksgiving. Of more immediate concern are some of the things pending. That's a long-term proposition of tax reform bill. But there's some more other legislation that are pending right now, Mr. President. And the first one that we're concerned about is the sanctions, South Africa sanctions bill. Prior to the recess, the House adopted that conference report. The Senate did not take.
How do you do? Mr. President, good to see you.
Let's square around here and look real formal. With smiles. Well, this is a happy and sad occasion. Happy because I know two very wonderful people are going to be representing us in Germany, but sad because we're going to miss you very much.
Well, I apologize, sir, for taking Gail away.
Well, but I can well understand
why I'm going. Yes.
Well, Nancy and I are happy that at least you're going to be around a little longer.
That's right. Here. That's right.
Not too much longer.
No,
just,
I know.
Just through Tuesday, but really, in a sense, I'll still be working for you.
Well, yes.
Both will.
Yes. And we wish you the very best.
Thank you. You know, we'll do anything we can.
You certainly made my job easier in Germany. Well, they are courageous decisions. I saw a headline in USA Today that said that Nixon would be elected president of China if they had an election, because he's there. But you could be elected president of Germany anytime you wanted. So if you can call me up and I'll put your name on the ballot.
All right.
And someday you ought to think about coming back to Germany, and if you do, I promise we won't make you visit a cemetery.
I enjoyed it. Well, you're following a great statesman on our behalf over there, and I have every confidence that you will follow him well and capably.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Well, God bless you both.
Thank you. Thank you.
All right. Never got to kiss the bride before.
God bless you, Mr. President.
Well, God bless both of you. Thank you for what you're doing. All right.
Yeah.
Oh, wait a minute. What am I talking about? Just a little souvenir. I don't want you to forget this.
Thank you.
Okay. Can you hold it, or do you want me to
carry
it? All right.
Bye.
Well, I feel good.
Okay.
Let's have a picture taken, and then we'll have a family picture.
Okay.
Now
that misses my list.
Hello.
Congratulations on your recovery.
Well,
I think it's marvelous. I'm sure it's your positive attitude.
And this is Janice.
Hi.
To see you.
And Chris.
Hi.
Hi. How are you?
And Sue.
Hello.
And Bradford, who has a letter to you from his class out in Arizona.
Bradford.
You going to give him the letter?
Yeah.
Well, thank you very much.
Thank you. Open at the top, and he's got letters from your class and some pictures.
Well,
last year they had a project in their class on what it means to be an American, and they did this because the teacher said American ends in I can. Isn't that nice?
Yes, it really is. Well, this is, well, I don't take the time. I will be looking at this very thoroughly.
Okay.
And
that's Kathy.
Oh.
Hello there. And Court.
Hello there.
And Sunny.
How do you do, Mr. President?
Hello.
And Gordon.
President.
Well,
so
they will all be hearing from me, but please tell them how very grateful I am for all of this.
They're big fans of the President's, aren't they, Brad?
Yep.
So
maybe we could get everybody out here for a photo.
Okay. Thank you.
Inside's what's important, it's jelly beans.
We'll let you go off your diet just for
yes.
So
Nothing before, none of those before lunch.
I brought this for you. It's from a trip I took to Ireland.
Say thank you very much.
You're welcome. Special Arizona trip.
She hand polished that just for you.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I appreciate that very much. A few Western items.
Well, I really appreciate this.
Well.
So.
Great pleasure to see you.
And get well fast.
Yeah. All right.
Okay.
Faster than the medics wanted to admit. That's a constant battle with the wrench.
Oh, really?
I won.
You always
did? I was on a horse and they weren't.
Oh, that's great. So.
But no, I really do. I'm very fortunate that I just feel great.
Well, that's wonderful. And thank you very much. We'll hope to see you again.
Thank you.
And
thank you for what you're doing.
Thank you. So we'll sneak out here. Hi, how are you?
Good night, and thanks again.